In this video, I'd like to show how to find t-critical values or t-scores for hypothesis test. You need a t-table. Also, you need to know the meanings of hypothesis test and critical values. Here's the t-table we use. The first column shows the degrees of freedom, which we can find by subtracting one from the sample size. The second and the third rows show either one-tailed or two-tailed significance level. The intersections of those give t-scores. Comparing to the standard normal distribution, the shape of t-distributions depends on the sample size. The t-distribution is used if we don't know the standard deviation of the population sigma. First, find the t-critical value for right-tailed test. There are two steps to find it. However, before starting, check to see if the population standard deviation sigma is given or not. Check the second condition, either the sample size is more than or equal to 30, or the population is normally distributed. Step 1, identify the significance level alpha as one-tailed area. Step 2, find the degrees of freedom by subtracting one from the sample size. Then look up the table. Let's take a look at the first example. Find the t-critical value for a right-tailed test with alpha equal 0.05 and a sample size of 13. Assume that the population standard deviation sigma is unknown and the population is normally distributed. Step 1, identify the significance level 0.05 as one-tailed alpha. Step 2, find the degrees of freedom by subtracting 1 from the sample size 13, which is 12. Then look up the table. First, locate 12 degrees of freedom. Then select 0.05 from one-tailed alpha row. Then the intersection of those is the t-score 1.782. We found the t-score as 1.782. Since this is a right-tailed test, the critical value should be positive. So the t-critical value for this test is 1.782. Next, find the t-critical value for left-tailed test. We need three steps to find it. Step 1, identify the significance level alpha as one-tailed area. Step 2, find the degrees of freedom by subtracting 1 from the sample size. Then look up the table. Step 3, place a negative sign to the t-score. Let's take a look at the example for left-tailed test. Find the critical value with alpha equal 0.01 and the sample size of 37. Assume that the population standard deviation sigma is unknown. Since the sample size is more than 30, the second condition is satisfied. Step 1, identify the significance level 0.01 as one-tailed alpha. Step 2, find the degrees of freedom by subtracting 1 from the sample size 37, which is 36. Then look up the table. First, locate 36 degrees of freedom. Then select the 0.01 from one-tailed alpha row. Then the intersection of those is the t-score 2.434. Now we find the positive critical value 2.434. However, this is a left-tailed test, it must be negative, So the critical value for this test is negative 2.434. Lastly, let's find out t critical values for two tailed tests. There are three steps to find them. Step 1, identify the significance level alpha as two-tailed area. Step 2, find the degrees of freedom by subtracting 1 from the sample size. Then look up the table. Step 3, please keep in mind that our t-table gives only positive t-scores. However, we should have both positive and negative t-critical values for two-tailed test. As the last example, find the t-critical values for a two-tailed test with alpha equal 0.01 and a sample size of 15. Assume that population standard deviation sigma is unknown and the population is normally distributed. Step 1, identify the significance level 0.01 at two-tailed alpha. Step 2, find the degrees of freedom by subtracting 1 from the sample size 15, which is 14. Then look up the table. First, locate 14 degrees of freedom. Then select 0.01 from 2/3 alpha row. Then the intersection of those is the t-score 2.977. Now we found the positive critical value 2.977. However, this is a two-tailed test. The critical value must be both negative and positive. So the t-critical values for this test are plus or minus 2.977. In summary, we need to identify the significance level alpha and find the degrees of freedom to look up the t-table. Please make sure that our t-table gives only positive t-scores. Therefore, we need to switch positive t-scores to negative values for left-tailed test and must have both negative and positive values for two-tailed test. Thank you for watching and see you next time.